The final approach in this form deconstruction section is using a form track to plan your own song. So unlike before, when you took an existing song and created a form track out of it, with this approach, you'll create a form track first and then create a song based on that form. You again use one silent MIDI track to mark sections, and then you create the full form track for your song. Then you can build your song part by part once that form track is complete. Let's look at that in the studio. So you can see I've already created a form track and I've labeled each section. The way to do this is say add new track, click any of these software instruments, it doesn't matter because it's not going to make any sound, label that form, and then you can add a new region by right-clicking and saying create region. In this case, I need to zoom in and grab the end of that and bring it here to make it a little longer. This first section is going to be 16 measures. I also want to turn off cycle mode, and then I'll label that track. So I'll go to edit, edit name, and in this case, this is the intro. So I want to label that intro, and then I'll just repeat that process. I might decide I want my verse to be 8 measures or 16 measures. It's up to me, but the idea is first create this form track that we see here, and then I can start adding new instruments. Like maybe I want to write some drum parts first, or maybe I want to write the lyrics first. But the point is, as I go, as I'm creating this song, I can see here inside the project where each section stops and starts, and even where each section repeats. So once I write my pre-chorus and chorus, I can see here again that that comes back. So once I've written it once, I know I can just repeat it right here and right here. Hopefully this is a useful approach for you as you're writing a song, knowing the form to guide you as you finish the rest of the parts.